Hi, dry eye community. I'm Dr. Brill here in Kansas City, and I see a lot of patients with dry eye, and they have a lot of times have a question about what type of dry eye do I have? Am I deficient in any aspect of my tears? Well, we dry eye doctors kind of answer this by saying we have two main types of dry eye. One that is, we call it aqueous deficiency dry eye, and the other one is called evaporative dry eye. That really means that you're deficient in the oils or lipids. So today we're going to show you how we measure the aqueous deficient dry eye with two different tests. One's called ZoneQuick and the other one is called Schirmer's. And today I'm going to go over how we test this. So we've got the traditional test called a Schirmer's test, and it's not one that we use very often. And we have the other one called ZoneQuick, and it's also called phenol red thread test. So I'm going to demonstrate how we use these today, so you'll know when you see your doctor, are they actually measuring if I'm deficient in the aqueous or liquid layer or the oily layer. So the ZoneQuick test involves two yellow threads, and I'm going to actually place one of them over our patient here's lid, and it's only a 15-second test. The other one involves a strip of essentially filter paper, and I'll open it up in a little bit, and it's a 5-minute test. So what would you rather have, a 15-second test or a 5-minute test? We prefer the 15-second test. So let me open this up here, and we've got a nice patient here. So it's got little yellow string, and I'm gonna actually pull one out. All right, I'm gonna put this little thin thread right on our patient's eyelid. We're going to go in the outer part here. Debbie, just look up to the ceiling if you would. And we're going to count to 15 here. Ten. Okay, it's 15 seconds. Now, if you can see this, there is a part that is the yellow, and there's a part that's red on this thread here. I'm gonna go ahead and measure that and just see what her, what the measurement is here. And so it looks like Debbie's ZoneQuick score is 20. She produced 20 millimeters of water in 15 seconds. Well, let's make it, it's changing a little bit. 13 millimeters of water in 15 seconds. All right, now if I were to do the other test, it's called a Schirmer test. This is more an older test. A lot of times it's done in research. And this is gonna stay on her eye for 5 minutes, which is extraordinarily long. I might end it earlier if it gets wadded up right away. So there's a little bend here, and it's kind of a measurement on there. So let me go ahead and bend that over her lid. Okay, Debbie, go ahead and look up to the ceiling again. Look straight upwards, please. And you can blink anytime you feel like it, but it'll be a little irritating. Okay, look up to the ceiling. Okay, good. So usually people are able to tear this up in a matter of seconds, but somebody, let's say with Sjogren's syndrome, may not tear it up at all, and they may really be dry. So it's good if somebody's totally dry, but it's irritating enough that most of the time it's not very accurate. Of course, we could do this with anesthetic too, but this would be a base. And let's see how you're doing here with watering that up. So we are not gonna make her suffer for the whole 5 minutes because that would be cruel and unusual punishment. So this is how I'm gonna take this out here. So this is how we measure aqueous deficiency, fairly straightforward, and we don't have to guess. So we like doing scientific method of all the aspects of analysis of someone's tear film in determination of what's the cause of the dry eye and what can we do about it. Thank you for watching, and this is how to do a diagnostic measurement of dry eye for aqueous deficiency.